सीबी डिपार्टमेंट वेट इंद्रप्रस्थ इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी दिल्ली विच इज IIIT दिल्ली. इट वॉज क्रिएटेड एज अ स्टेट यूनिवर्सिटी बाय एन एक्ट ऑफ दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट एम्पावरिंग इट टू डू रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट एंड ग्रांट डिग्रीज. Established in 2008, the university has grown to be recognized as one of the most promising young institutions for education and research in India. IIIT Delhi currently has 6 departments: computer science, electronics and communication, computational biology, human centered design, social science and humanities, and mathematics. The objective of the computational biology or CB department is to conduct outstanding research at the interface of biological sciences and computer sciences to bridge the gap between diverse biological streams, starting from biological network to molecular biology to computational fields, including algorithmic developments, high performance computing, data science, etc. This all was just a brief introduction about IIIT Delhi and CB department. About me, I am Ayushi, an alumni of Masters CB batch 2016 to 2018. So without taking too much of your time, I would like to introduce you about the process we will follow during the session. We have divided the session into 4 categories. First will be academic overview of MTech CB's program, courses offered, semester planning, etc., which will be taken by Siddhant Kalra and Ayush Garg. Both are 2020 graduates. Research and placement opportunities, Sana and Divya. They will share their experiences, where Sana is 2019 pass out and Divya is recent graduate 2020. Then scope of CB entrepreneurship skills, which will be introduced by Nikita and Shubhra, and both are 2018 pass outs. And the remaining thoughts about the student club, life at the campus, and other facilities will be summarized by Arvind and me. And we both are 2018 passouts. Each of the 4 categories will be of 10 minutes. And after every session, we will take your questions for 5 minutes on that particular session. Everyone is requested to put your question in the chat box, and we will ensure that each question is answered. But I request you to ensure that the question you ask should be relevant to the preceding category only and relevant to the computational biology department. Before ending the session, we will take all those questions related to the CB department that would have been missed during the session, or maybe because of time, or maybe you missed to mention it. We will take all those questions in the end related to CB department. And before we start, I request everyone to ensure that they are on mute. Now I hand over the stage to Siddhant and Ayush to give an academic overview of MTech CB program.
Hey everyone, my name is Siddhant and I joined the MTech program in computational biology at IIIT Delhi in 2018 and have completed it a few weeks back. I did my final year research project on finding the role of chemosensory receptors in cancer progression. Currently, I have 3 PhD offers with me from US, Germany, and Sweden, and will soon be joining one of them. Today, I will be discussing with you the academic overview of the computational biology program. Since people with different backgrounds, such as biology, CSE, and ECE, join this course, so before beginning the actual MTech program, IIIT offers you a foundation course, which is also known as the refresher module. It usually lasts for 3 to 4 weeks, during which you will be taught the basics of biology, probability, algebra, coding and data structures in Python as well as in R. The aim of this module is that people with diverse background should come to the same level before starting their actual MTech program. By the end of this course, you have to appear for an exam, which includes theoretical as well as the coding question. Though the courses and the grades you obtain in this refresher module won't be counted in the credit requirement nor in your CGPA, but still it is mandatory for you to appear and pass these exams. The total credits required for CB courses are 32 plus 16. 32 are for your coursework and 16 are for your thesis. For each semester, you can take up to maximum 20 credits of load. During first semester, you have to take few mandatory courses such as Foundations of Modern Biology, which is a 4 credit course, In this particular course, you will be taught about the structure of DNA, RNA, protein, how cell divides, growth and development, Mendelian and non-Mendelian genetics. The second mandatory course is Algorithms in Computational Biology, which again is a 4-credit course. In this course, you will learn different programming algorithms such as sorting, searching, greedy algorithms, dynamic programming. Your entire assignments for this particular course will be in Python language. Your third mandatory course is Cell Biology and Biochemistry, which again is a 4-credit course. This course basically focuses on the reaction mechanism of the chemical compounds, their stereochemistry, chemical kinetics, and introduction to some differential equation. The assignments that you will receive in this course will be in MATLAB. The last mandatory course is Object-Oriented Programming and Design. It is a 2-credit course, and it is not the part of your 32-credit framework. So as the name suggests, you will learn about creating a class, abstraction, encapsulation, inheritance. The entire course for CB student will be in Python. Apart from this, you also have some TA duties and other courses, which Ayush will be discussing with you.
Hey everyone, my name is Ayush Garg. I recently graduated from MTech CB program in 2020. I did my thesis project on learning gene interactions from public literature and genomic data. I'm currently placed in TCS Research and Innovation Lab. So continuing to what Siddhant has told you, let's continue your academic journey from semester two. Unlike semester one, this semester offers you to opt for some elective courses apart from the mandatory courses. There are two mandatory courses, Introduction to Mathematical Biology, which is a 4-credit, which introduces mathematical concepts of ordinary and partial differential equations as applied in the quantitative study of biological systems and biological data analysis. And second course is Research Methods, which is a 2-credit course, but that does not count towards your 32 credits, but still is calculated in your CGPA. And this course focuses on the skills of scientific reading, writing, presentation, and carrying out a literature review for research. Apart from this, you can take electives either from the CB department or any other department. These can be interdisciplinary courses like which the CSA department offers, like machine learning, virtual reality, computer vision, or you can take CB related courses as well, like data science and genomics, network science. And these courses are like optional, depending upon your interest, you can choose for any. You can also opt for independent project or independent study, which can vary from 2 to 4 credits. And you kind of do a minor project under a faculty of IIIT Delhi. Then to further focus, for your degree requirement, you have to complete 20 credits of CB courses out of the 32 courses. So which gives you only 12 credits to explore the interdisciplinary courses. Then in semester 3 and 4, majority of your course credits have been finished and majorly 16 credits of your thesis work, which is mandatory, are left. So generally people do divide the thesis in 8 credits each semester, but that's up to you how you want to play along. And then you can also go for elective courses. There can be different purpose to take the courses, like to complete your credit or to audit the course for learning purpose. You can go for extra credits as well. And you can either go for course replacement, in which you can replace a course with a previously taken course in which you haven't scored very good. Apart from this, sharing my thesis experience, I did my industrial thesis from a company, Elucidator Corporation. IIITD offers an opportunity to pursue a research project in the industry, although there are some guidelines that needs to be followed, like the research problem should be related to the field of CB. The internal guide has to be a IIITD faculty, and the mentor who is mentoring you in the company has to be a PhD. And lastly, the minimum CGPA for degree requirement that one must obtain is 6.5. Now, Siddhant will be sharing his experience of doing this, the thesis project in the academia.
So I did my thesis within the institute under Dr. Gaurav Ahuja. I want to say that every faculty at IIIT Delhi is working on some really good quality research problems, and they are super helpful. You are free to take thesis in any of within any of the CB faculty or in as well as in the CS department. but the question of your research should be related to CB department only. Apart from this, if you will visit the site in the adjunct faculty, you can also take thesis under them. IIIT Delhi has an MOU signed with the IJIB Institute. If you do your thesis with these particular people which have been mentioned here, there is no need for any internal guide, but you are free to take thesis like Ayush mentioned in the industry or in any institute. But it has to be guided with the, it has to be followed a certain norms which your MTech coordinator will be telling you. So for more information, you can visit these two sites.
Thank you, Siddhant. Is there anything else we are looking for from Siddhant and Ayush?
No. We can take up the question.
Yeah. So can we start with some questions like, guys, do we have any question on this thing? Up to the, on academic background and all those requirements, any research-based question, anything else? Okay, so there's a question from Vikas. What can we do, what we can do in spare time that we have before admission? So I guess he's trying to ask what are the things they should go through, read through before admission.
So before admission, you should try to get yourself a little bit knowledge about the basics of the biology, some coding aspect. You should try to improve your mathematical background. That will be really helpful.
Thank you, Siddhant. Any other question? So there's a question from Partha. Is the campus placements occur with, okay. So Partha, this is a question related to placement. We'll take this question once we move to the placement category. There's a question from Dinesh. I haven't studied biology formally after 10th class. Will it impact me if I'm looking for career in core CB? Siddhant and Ayush?
Personally, this is the same case. You won't suffer. It's just that you have to put in a little more effort towards the biology. That's the only thing.
Thank you, Ayush. Do we have more questions? Okay. So there's a question from Anshul. Can you convert to PhD after the first year? Anshul, again, this is some question that will be taken care in our placement and research domain, what to do after a master's or scope of doing CB in master's. This is completely related to academics, the things you will learn during your master's. So for Partha and Anshul, your questions will be taken care, they will be taken care within the category. Do we have any question related to academia and the thesis work, all these things? Yeah. So any CSE graduate alumni, problems they faced while pursuing this course, from Kiran Sethi. Ayush, I guess you are from CS background. So
So majorly problems are that there is a like initial pickup time that you have to spend on the biological aspects like the DNA, RNA, protein structure. We don't have that kind of background, but in the refresher module, those things are taken care of. And, you know, like the batchmates help a lot, and you in the group, you can just get along with this. Means that's not major bottleneck, I won't say that.
Thank you, Ayush. Sharon, so a question asked by Sharon is, which company, what was the name of the company at which you did your thesis? It is a question to Ayush.
So that was Elucidata Corporation.
So it is Elucidata.
Yeah.
Another question from Vikash, which was answered by Siddhant earlier. What programming languages do we have to learn other than Python?
So other than Python, you can learn R and MATLAB.
Guys, some more questions, please. I guess we are done with the questions, and anyway, we are running with the time. So for now, okay, so there is one more question. Is there any research going on in gene modification? This would be the last question we'll be taking from Kushal.
So the link that I have shared with you, you can go to the site and you can actually see the area in which the faculty is working. Definitely some of the faculty are working with gene modification, some are working on networks and other things. So you can visit the individual faculty website to check which domain they are working.
So in addition to the question by Kushal, there is one more question from Neeraj Tripathi. Along with gene modification, they want to ask about genomics, transcriptomics and proteomics.
So again, when you will look at the faculty profile, you will definitely get what all papers they have published, and from that you can take an idea that which faculty is working on the which domain.
Thank you, Ayush and Siddhant. If you guys have any other question left within this category and missed to ask, then I guess one question from Neeraj Tripathi has been missed. Does elective focus on omics data analysis? Then I request Neeraj will take care of this question in the end of the session. Siddhant and Ayush will be there to answer your question. So now I hand over the stage to Divya and Sanat to overview the team about research and placement opportunities.
Yes, hello everyone. My name is Divya and I recently graduated from IIIT Delhi with a degree in M.Tech CB. I was the placement coordinator for 2018-2020 batch, and we also have Sana with us. Hello Sana.
Hi.
Yeah. So we are here to discuss about placement and research opportunities. So as all of us know, computational biology is recognized as an essential element in modern biological and biomedical research. And there have been fundamental changes in biology and medicine over the past two decades due to spectacular advances in high throughput data collection in the fields of genomics, proteomics, and biomedical imaging. The resulting availability of unprecedented amounts of biological data demands the application of advanced computational tools to build integrated models of biological systems and to use them to devise deliverable strategies to prevent or treat diseases. Computational biologists inhabit and expand the interface of computation and biology, making them integral to the future of biology and medicine. Computational biology is a growing field, and not only in academia, but also in industry. Major players in computation and medicine have invested heavily in computational biology, including Google, Microsoft, Life Technologies, Roche and Merck. Many startups are also coming up in this sector. So with a degree in computational biology, students can work in the commercial, academic, and government domains. Titles like computer and information research scientist, or data scientist, or data analyst are usually associated with the ones having the background in this education. So not just in academics, but also in industries, computational biology is growing at an impressive rate. Today, job prospects within computational biology seem strong and appear to be growing, buoyed by pharmaceutical and biotech industries looking to take advantage of the ends of genomics data and usher in a new era of drug discovery. So in the research and development sector of biotech, pharmaceutical and scientific software companies, a computational biologist is a very popular job profile. Students can also join the research field as their career. They can join various research labs in India and abroad. So the computational biology course at IIIT Delhi prepares the students both for research and industry. According to the record of past few years, 50% of students prefer to go with research, while other 50% took industries as their career option. The companies that visited the campus solely for CB students include PCS Research, Strand Life Sciences, INAQ, Circle of Life, The Gene Box, MedGenome, LAC Data, and many others, with a package ranging between 8 to 12 lakhs per annum. Most of these companies had the CGPA cutoff as the basic graduation requirement cutoff, that is 6.5. And students are also eligible to apply for the companies that come to recruit for other branches like CSE. And students can take up either research or industries as their career, depending on their choice. So we are open to questions now.
Sana, do you want to add on this?
So I would talk about my experience at IIIT. Currently, I am a PhD scholar here at University of Kansas in the United States. And I have been an alumni and also an active member in the placement committee in the last year, in the year 2017 to 2020. What I have observed is you really need, when you begin, you really do not need a very strong coding or heavily biology dominated background. Over the course of over the period of the course, you can actually build up your skills. And as better as you get with these skills, it's easier for you to tap on the opportunities in various fields, be it research, be it industry, and you can have as much exposure as you want to based on what you want to experience. Also, based on the thesis requirements that we have, if you already have a plan, if you would want to join an industry by the completion of the course or for higher studies, try to align your thesis in a similar way so that you end up achieving your goals in a much realistic manner. This just makes it easier for you. Apart from that, you always have A plus companies that, like how Divya mentioned, that constantly visit the campus for recruitments, and the recruitments have been very active. Everybody is really active. The faculty also encourages you to explore internship opportunities before getting a full-time placement offer so that you are well acquainted with the procedure and you would get a better idea if you would want to continue with the current internship or would you want to switch it to a higher study offer. If you happen to get a higher study offer like I have, you can choose to opt out of the placement process so that you do not block the seats for other individuals. And it's better to have a clear vision or plan by the end of the tenure of the course. And that usually happens with people. So you always get a clear idea as to what you want to do. We can go ahead and take more questions if you have regarding the placement opportunity.
Sure. So there was a question from Partha. Is the campus placements occur with the MTech CS department?
So in case of CB, what really happens is when you become a part of MTech CB program, if you are very well versed in algorithms, heavily programming dominated, you would definitely, during the course, you might want to switch to opportunities which are offered by the CSE companies, also because you hail from that particular background as well. But it's always beneficial to stick to a certain domain and try to explore opportunities within the same region, as in try to explore as many opportunities within the MTech CB background and try to get I'm sure you can explore MTech CSE opportunities as well, but according to the department, it is always preferred that you always stick to the MTech CB opportunities that are being offered for you.
One more question from Anshul. Can you convert to PhD after the first year?
I think this basically depends on the rapport with the... there is a process of midway converting the PhD to the MTech process to a PhD, and you have to be convincing enough and have good talks with a certain professor. I think that's a very mutual discussion between the professor and the student, but I'm sure that that's a possibility. And if somebody is keen on converting their MTech to a PhD during the course, or you can parallelly achieve both the processes as well. After MTech, you can immediately switch to PhD within one of the professors in the same department. That has been a case that has been observed previously as well. We have a couple of seniors who have switched to a PhD opportunity with different professors with which they have been doing their thesis because their work was really good, and they have done that in the past times. So I'm sure that's an opportunity, but you can always discuss it with your professor when you're joining.
So there's one more question from Sayan, which revolves around TA duties and all these things, which will be taken care in the last minutes of the session because that was something related to academic. So, but there's one more question from Surbhi that she has seen some companies like Microsoft have dedicated CB departments for research work, but not in India. Can you name some research labs or universities or companies for either for industrial purpose or academia or research within India?
So it's a very, very good question. And a lot of people really don't know about this, but a lot of big labs which function in these areas are TCS Research and Innovation Labs. Like we have a couple of alumni which are working there. And there's Strand Life Sciences, which are actively working. And there's Tata Research Development and Design, to name a few. These have been very, very, these are all AA plus category. They give you good packages. They have good solid standing in the market. And they are some of the companies, high-end companies that you would say, that are dedicated to core CB programs and CB-dominated projects actively going on with artificial intelligence, deep learning, machine learning, and a lot of other prospects that you could explore.
Yeah, thank you, Sana. There's a question from Dinesh. What is the career in data science after doing master's in CB?
So the best part is that the CB course actually has a very, very good a course, a part of the course curriculum, which has subjects which aligns with data science, machine learning, and there is a whole lot of opportunities with respect to data science if you would want to explore it within India or if you would want to explore it overseas. Data science is the current trending thing in the market with respect to any particular field. I think Ayushi herself is also working as a data scientist, and a lot of other graduates also from the department are working as data scientists. And also, now we know that we have a lot of data coming from biology every single day. We need data scientists to analyze these data, to break them down and to get relevant and to give out relevant information to people in the market. And you definitely have a lot of consumers for that. So there is a lot of opportunities for data science in terms of research and industries, either ways, both in India, and you can actually explore a lot of other opportunities with data science further as well. I hope that.
There's a question from, thank you, Sana. There's a question from Sharon. If you plan for a PhD, what are your research options during final semester?
If I would consider this particular question, it basically means that if you are already planning for a PhD, like I said, you would always plan your thesis in accordance to what you would want to pursue maybe further, even if it is you are trying to pursue a PhD within the same department in IIIT, or if you're exploring for opportunities outside. The major research options being, you have a lot of faculties which are actively working in different areas, from machine learning to database development to computational gastronomy and a lot of other things. So there is a whole lot of things to explore. So you need to be vigilant enough as to what PhD opportunities you're planning to tap on, and what kind of a thesis would you want to do, and how effective that thesis needs to be so that you grab a certain opportunity related to your PhD.
There is a question from Vikash. Can we apply to companies like Microsoft and Amazon as a software engineer from campus or off campus?
So this is this question is a little tricky, because what usually, how should I put it? Usually what happens is, because you hail from a CB background, when you apply for companies like this, when they see you that you're coming from an MTech CB program, you are always the second choice for these companies if they do not have a program or, say, a project which is running solely on biology. They would happily be taking you up. But if they do not, then they always have candidates from the EC and the CS backgrounds. But if you are competent enough, you're good enough, and you convince them that you are better than the EC and the CSE students, you can probably definitely change the course of time and actually bag an opportunity. I don't see any problem in that. But
So Sana, there is one more question from Satakshi. It will be really helpful if you highlight some career future in faculty, as a faculty within CB department, after doing masters without PhD.
Okay. For teaching purposes, I'm not too sure, but I'm pretty sure that, so this person said that if I plan to teach in future in colleges, would MTech CB would be, so what I feel like in India, I think it is kind of compulsory to have a PhD degree and a certain set of publications to yourself before you get appointed as a lecturer in a certain college. But I think teaching opportunities at the school level would be a possibility for sure. I am not too sure about the state and the government universities if you're trying to look at the teaching opportunities. And it would also vary from person to person based off on the kind of experience that you have or you hold after you complete your MTech CV. So say, for example, if you have a lot of work experience in different industries and then you do an MTech CV, so probably that might be an added advantage and help you gain an opportunity. But I'm sure you need a certain set of publications and you need some kind of research experience prior to your teaching experience for sure. That's what I feel.
Yeah. Thank you, Sana and Divya. I would like to share, I would like to say, ki let's take further questions on the placements and research in the end of the call. Before for that, so I would request Shubhra and Nikita to take forward about the CV entrepreneurship skills.
Hi, everyone. I'm Shubhra. I joined the MTech CV program in 2016. And I would, so I'm currently working as a bioinformatics engineer at Elucidata, which is a data slash software company based in Delhi. So before, can you hear me?
Yeah, go on, Shubhra. Yeah, go on.
So instead of talking about my personal experience, like I'll get to some of the kind of job opportunities that exist within a data slash software startup. I would actually first talk about how this company was started, right? Like, so who are the founders? How did they think of this idea and how did they take it forward? So the founders, so we have two founders for Elucidata. One is Dr. Abhishek Jha, who is a computational biologist. And the other is Shweta Pathak, who is a math and computer graduate from IIT Delhi. And like the idea originated when Dr. Jha was working at a pharmaceutical company as a computational biologist. And he kind of saw how biologists are working with their data and what are the challenges that they're facing. And he realized that there is a huge requirement for people who can bridge that gap between scientists and software engineers. What used to happen earlier when he was there was that the biologists would have no clue of how to work with softwares, let alone build new softwares. And they would keep, there was no sense of data management. There was no sense of how do you transfer data from one place to another? How do you store it? How do you process it? Most of those responsibilities fell onto the IT team. And again, the IT team has their own specific expertise, right? They don't know what to do with biological data. So that kind of requirement, he realized that companies like pharmaceutical companies like this are going to face a lot in the future as well. Which is where the idea for Elucidata came along. The main motive for Elucidata is basically to help help researchers, whether industrial or academic, in managing their data, in automating their pipelines, helping them set up structures so that their scientists don't have to struggle with data. They can focus on the data analysis rather than actually data wrangling and how do you process it and stuff like that. That was started in, say, I think 2015 or 16, 2014 or 15. And now we are here in 2020 working with some of the big names in pharmaceutical industry, whether it's Pfizer or whether it's SciEx or it's like other academic labs at Yale or MIT or VIB. Yeah, so that's been kind of a journey, and we've had to find the perfect product market fit. But the idea at the base of it all was started from a computational biologist's mind to see what the requirement in the field is. The field did not think of the requirement and approach him. It was the other way around. He had to create that requirement. He had to make the industry realize that, you know what, you need this. And he's kind of built that from the ground up there. So yeah, CB opportunity, apart from that, like Nikita will take the part about how do you start. So Nikita is an entrepreneur herself in the CB field, and she will talk to you about how to build a startup. Before that, I would just like to reiterate that the kind of roles that you can expect when you've done CB, MTech CB from IIITB. So in Elucidator, we have multiple roles. You have data analysts, you have data scientists, you have bioinformatics scientists, you have bioinformatics engineers, and you have like data managers and data wranglers, machine learning experts as well. So all of these people have overlapping but very different roles and expertise. And all of those are, and IIIT MTech CB course really prepares you well for pretty much any of those roles. It's really your pick at that point, whether you want to be a data analyst or whether you want to be an ML expert or whether you want to be a bioinformatics scientist. So yeah, I'll take questions later, but for now I think I'll pass the baton to Nikita.
Hi everybody. First of all, I would like to congratulate all of you to be present here, because CB opens a huge door of opportunity for you guys. Trust me on that. So as Shubhra talked about, a great example of how a computational biologist could actually build a foundation of a very strong company in India, I would like to talk about how you can do it. So talking about myself, I am Nikita. I am a director and a co-founder to a company by the name of Chimera. It's a two-year-old company, and within this 2 years, we've had a big grant from Department of Biotechnology. We also recently got a grant for developing COVID curative solution from Department of Science and Technology. We also have a patent, and we also have an algorithm underway, which is for HLA matchmaking. And all of this could have been possible because I would give a lot of credit to IIIT Delhi, because that was the platform where I could actually explore this field, which is amazing at this point, because they actually teach you both biology, computational biology, and this is where actually industry lies. This is what I feel, that the industry really lies at the intersection of biology and computer science, because as Sana pointed out, as Shubhra pointed out, that there's abundant of data which is there in biology. And they need actually people who could crunch that data into a meaningful manner, and that is really required. Coming to what if you really want to go ahead with entrepreneurship, this is your time, 2 years, to explore the ideas that you're really interested in. And trust me, government has got platforms where you can actually project your skills, and they would accelerate your push. Talking about government, Department of Biotechnology has started a program called BIRAC, where they fund entrepreneurs, young entrepreneurs like us, to come showcase their ideas, and rest you can leave it up to them. Where you have an idea, you just need to apply for it. The idea should be compelling enough, and that is it. From there to actually getting to the market is something that they help you do. They have incubator cells. IIIT also has one incubator center where you can incubate. You can get mentorship for your business models. You can get mentorship for your product design. All you need is just a compelling idea, and that I think IIIT has got abundant opportunities lying within the subjects that they teach that can really get you through those ideas. So this was something that I wanted to talk about. I can take up questions now.
Thank you, Shubhra and Nikita. And guys, do we have, let's shoot questions. So we have two or three more minutes. Okay, so we got a question from Neeraj Tripathi asking for entrepreneurship, one need to cultivate ideas and knowledge on servers, infrastructure, architecture, as well as communication skills. Does IIIT Delhi help us on that?
Anyone? Yeah, actually, yes, because here you would, you if you have an idea, you've got amazing mentors who could help you, you know, synergize all of this together and come up with a really strong idea. Yes, you're right, with an idea, you would want to cultivate all of this. And you just need to, you know, be proactive in your approach. And you really have mentors there for each and everything to help you actually stitch the idea together and, you know, bring it forward.
Yeah, apart from that, like even the courses that you take as part of the CBE curriculum, right? A lot of those actually prepare you for, like they give you a decent sense of computer science as well, apart from just biology. So your knowledge on servers, infrastructure and architecture will not be, I won't say it will be comparable to a CSE grad, but it's not like you will be clueless. And if you put your mind to it and if you work with a CSE faculty, right, while you're doing your research, I think that will help a great deal. And the great part is about this course is that it allows you that freedom to explore outside of CBE as well. Yeah. So yeah, and communication skills, definitely. That is definitely a strong plus when you do a course here. Whether it's scientific communication or whether it's, you know, how to work in teams, how to, like, as part of your TA-ship as well, that's also part of how you develop your communication skills. So, yeah.
So, there is one more question from Kushal, which is there any or any scope of agriculture setup related to CB, where I feel you guys can mention about gastronomica and food area, food research happening in our campus? Shubhra?
So that's a very interesting question. And short answer is yes. There are a lot of companies focused more on agriculture, you know, agriculture-related algorithms. Recently, I met a guy who's wanting to actually develop an AI model to actually judge the conditions of crop a priori, so that, you know, actually they can take up measures to prevent any hazard. And you can look more for it on BIRACS and DBT's websites. They've got a number of projects on CB based on agriculture listed there.
Thank you, Nikita. There's one more question from Sayan. Can an alumni of IIIT Delhi take help from incubation center of IIIT Delhi, or it is just for current students?
I think yes. Alumni can also take help from IIIT Delhi. As far as I know, in the BIRAC network, they have incubation centers from IIT Delhi and other institutes as well, where you don't need to be an alumni also. You can go register, put up an application, and if they find an application compelling, so they take you in. So that is how it works. And I think for IIIT Delhi, it's the same procedure.
Yeah, so even within IIIT Delhi, there is an incubation center which supports alumni also by providing some funds, but they have some conditions which you can check on their websites. And now there's one more question from Dinesh. Dinesh, this is a question related to placements, which I would prefer to take in the end. Question from Apoon, will it hamper me in placements in course CB industry since I am from, okay, so this is again a placement related question. I will take it in end. I didn't get the name of the startup mentioned by Nikita. Could you please repeat or spell it?
Okay, it's Chimera. Chimera Translational Research Fraternity. I'll just write it down in the chat for you.
Yeah, mentioned by Shubhra. I guess Shubhra has already answered this question. Yeah. Thank you, Shubhra. There's one more question from, okay, so again, it is related to academics. I would take in the end. Is there any other question related to CB entrepreneurship and startup ideas? We still have 1 more minute. Yes, Nikita, you were saying something.
You mentioned the source where I can learn this. Could you please repeat the question?
So there is no question. We are just looking for other questions. I guess we are good to proceed with the next category, which is about the life at the campus and the facilities being provided by the campus. So I request Arvind to take the lead.
Hello, you can hear me, right?
Yeah, Arvind, thank you. Yeah.
Okay. Hello, everyone. First of all, I would like to thank every one of you to join today. And I would also like to thank the department to organize such open house. And also I would like to thank Ganesh sir and academic department for giving me an opportunity to speak about the campus life, the student community. So let me tell you about myself. I am Arvind Iyer, a 2016-18 batch, passed out from IIIT Delhi. And I'm very proud that I did Masters in Computational Biology from IIIT Delhi. Currently, I'm a PhD student in University of Lausanne, Switzerland, working in the domain of cancer. So far you have heard some wonderful stuff about academia, research, job opportunities from my batchmates and the juniors, which is what majority of the people look after for when they join for the master's course. I would like to point about something which IIIT gives underneath, which nobody understands it, but it's very important, is that IIIT develops your all-round skills, and IIIT believes in all-round development, and it believes that student leads in everything. And that's why IIIT has a system in which students are given more power. And I will just talk to you about what are this. So the student community is basically represented at every level, at every batch. And where are they represented? So the student community is basically represented by student council. So the student council is the main student body of the IIIT Delhi, which has a representative from every batch. I was the student representative at my time, and I was also fortunate enough to be the treasurer in that student council. So what is student council? The student council is basically has like a representative from every batch, BTech, MTech, PhD, and it is headed by the Dean of Academic Dean of Student Affairs, which is currently headed by Professor PK Ponnurangam Kumaraguru. So what does student council do? So the student council basically let's say you wanted a student community wants to have a chart house in the campus, and there is no chart house in the campus, let's say. So the student council tries to make sure that the students are looking for something like this. It brings up in the campus. Now this is about the student council. So there is one more student body which undercomes under the student council, which is student senate, which basically looked after your academic staff, where you also have a representative from the CB batch, which basically looks after, let's say, your course issues, timing issues, TA-ship issues, or you wanted to do some online course which is not available, you want to make some course available for yourself. So that representative puts forward your voice for your batch in the student senate and in the bigger hierarchy, which is headed by the Dean of Academic Affairs. Now this is more about the student council and what are the different things comes under it. Apart from this, you also have a cultural committee, which basically does a lot of events which we all enjoy, like there is an holy event, and then there is a lot of fun events which happen in the campus. The next important thing which I want to talk about is clubs, because I feel that when I joined after my bachelor's, I never saw this sort of stuff in the student community, where you have like so many clubs, and in each club you can go and join and do a lot of different activities. So what are the clubs? So the club is basically build upon some activity which a student wants to develop, and the IIIT funds for that. So the student community gets funded for doing some sort of activities. There are roughly 20 different clubs, like FUBAR, which is a programming club where majority of us took part to enhance our coding skills. Then there is BUILD, which is a software club. Then you have MATOS, which is a dance club. Then there is also BioBytes, which is a club which I and my batchmates founded back in 2016, and it's currently running by the bachelor student, which is more focused on the computational biology and different activities related to it. which is more about the clubs. You can go back, you can go and look into the student affairs page of the Triplied Delhi. You will get more information about more different clubs. So in nutshell, apart from this, you also have some public events like PyData conferences or Camtex health hackathons or any other event happening in the campus, which you will always get to know from your emails. So your emails will be regularly bundled with a lot of this activity is happening and this activity is happening, etc. So what all this helps in is that it basically helps you to learn a lot of leadership skills, communication skills, and basically overall develops your personality. And I guess I owe that a lot to Triplied Delhi, because I was fortunate enough to be the treasurer, also be part of student council. Also, I was part of different festivals. So Triplied has two different festivals. One is SCR, which happens roughly in this month, if I remember correctly. And then there is one more, which is the cultural festival, which happens in the next semester in the winter around January. So the student life and the student community is always bringing, and you always find people interacting and talking about different stuff. I just want to point out some more things. Like, I've seen people joining these clubs and then taking career forward in design. Some have taken career forward in some other domains. So it's always fascinating to see such student community where you can take part, and you can also create your own club. Let's say you are interested in something which is not there in Triplied Delhi and you want to build, you can also build that. Now I will just hand over to Aishi to talk about the beautiful campus we have and how's the life in the campus and what all fun we can do in the campus. Aishi, over to you.
Thank you, Arvind. So again, I would like to thank Ganesh, Shipra, and you guys to be here and give us this opportunity. So first thing I would say that the best way to judge before joining any program or any college or university, you always should look at your pass-out batches or the alumni. So you guys will be joining as the sixth batch for the CB department within the IIIT Delhi. And we are, I, Nikita, Ashubra, Arvind, we are the second batch passed out from IIIT Delhi in 2018 in CB as masters. And we are always happy to share our experience with any of the nth coming batch. The primary reason is the master's CB program has actually improved our lives drastically at the personal level and the professional level. Improvements and scope in the professional levels have already been discussed by various people, like Nikita shared her experience about entrepreneurship. Arvind shared his experience about the leadership skills he learned because of the students club and all these things, the PhD opportunities. Shubhra has already shared her industrial experience, how master's in CBA is helping her to cope up with to compete with the industrial people. But and along with this, there are multiple important factors involved to make your IIIT and the master's life a fun and happening, which are like friends, faculties, the campus area, and the different activities and the resources available within the campus. So most of us, like during our bachelor's, always take like, okay, we have more time to get our life settled. We have just passed out from the school. Let's spend time in all of fun and enjoying the parties, etc. But when you enter the master's, there's always one fear in all your mind that we need to get our life settled because this is the peak time. So over there are people within the campus to help you around you. Those are your friends, faculties, and the staff within our college. Now I will tell you how friends will help you to grow personally and professionally. So within your batch, there will be people from different domains. So within our batch, there were three from biotech areas and six or some were from computational area background. So we all together came up and helped computational science engineers, helped computer engineers, helps biotech people. Biotech people helped us in computers learning biological skills. We all, the moment when we joined IIIT Delhi, we were biotech engineers and computer engineers. But the moment when we graduated from IIIT Delhi, every one of us is a computational biologist. This is how each and every friend help each other. And like at the personal level, they ensure that you have all those late night outings. They don't let you miss your birthday party celebrations. They will ensure that your birthday is celebrated at the best. You will have freshers, farewells. And like I always used to miss few things we used to do during our masters. Like I don't know if I still remember how happening it used to be. Like we used to have a car and we all used to get into that small car as a complete batch, keep on singing songs loudly without taking care of what the society is thinking. We and our friend are just a society for us. So we used to pull each other's leg, finding love of others' life. So, and the best part was waking each other before the exam night. So all of it, and like there was one more instance during our freshers, I could never imagine that I could even think of doing a couple dance. But I've been forced to do that and I won first prize. So this was all because of the support from my batchmates, all of this. So I can easily see the batchmates and the friends around you will support you at a professional and personal level. This was more about the friends and batchmates. Now, the most important pillars of the CB masters are our faculties. They will always be there to help you. At no point we had to request any of the faculty member that they were, and they, as they were always with us. For our batch, Ganesh sir and Sriram sir were the two primary faculties who have taken care of all of us. And now you will have more faculties to reach out, and I assure you every one of them will be available at any point of time. Coming from personal experience, I was looking for a guidance because within like December 2019 or January 2020, I had two opportunities: a good paying, high paying job after 2 years of experience as data scientist, and a PhD to start within IIIT Delhi again with another professor. So the moment it was really difficult for me to drop out of a good paying job and join a PhD where I will get some stipend. I called up Ganesh sir, and I would say it was really a nice and helpful support from his end. He helped me in thinking of all possible questions that I should answer before taking any decision, and he supported me in my decision also. So along, these are the skills which you will learn beyond academics and coursework from your faculties. And yes, obviously coursework, the coding skills, all these will be, you guys will be trained. Faculties will help you a lot to train yourself. Then we have Shipra ma'am and Ashutosh Brahma sir, who are the pillars for CB department and master student within the IIIT Delhi. At the academic issues, if you need to get an access to any gadget or document or whatever you want, if you are facing any issue at any point of time, you can go to these two people and they will always help you. Going beyond all of it, still if you miss your family, home-cooked food, then we have a canteen to serve late night parathas. So canteen is 24/7 open. You can have parathas, Maggi with a cup of tea, all of this. Still, if you feel that you are missing your family and feeling mental pressure, then we have a well-being center available 24 hours where you can openly share your thoughts in a closed room. Then we have an infirmary available to take care of our health along with the support of Chandiwala Hospital that is just adjacent to our campus. And just to highlight this thought, that there are still 39 students within the campus during this lockdown. Because of some issues, the reasons they couldn't go home, but the campus and the authorities have taken care of those students. They don't face any of the issue, be it food or anything. Then we have sports complex, gym, yoga classes, indoor game opportunities, all these you can go and participate in other colleges' space. Then we have, the best part is you can get AC in Delhi summer at every time in your rooms, chai in Delhi winters at night. Then we have library, which is available 24/7 to ensure there's no resource crunch for you. And obviously you will have a dedicated seat within a lab for yourself to focus only on your work. So before I end up with highlighting the college facilities, The last thing I would say is, if you have a dream, then it is guaranteed that you will get a complete support and start your journey. As the incubation center in the institute also supports, and there is one more course which is being launched on entrepreneurship that will support your startup plans. And now, coming back from 2018, I was so impressed with the IIIT Delhi's faculty's support that I've rejoined the IIIT Delhi as a PhD student. So since again I'm a PhD student within a IIIT Delhi, I can be easily reached out at different email ID, which we will share in further. So this whole is about the overview of IIIT Delhi life, which is being conveyed by Arvind and me. If you guys have any question on this, then we are happy to take those questions. Yeah, so there is a question: what are the pros and cons of single room versus sharing? And do we have any information on how the classes will be carried online or offline for the same? So regarding single room versus sharing, so there are some policies about room allocation. During your first year of master's, you will get the sharing room just to ensure that you will not feel stressed sitting alone in a single room. And you will get an opportunity to interact at least with your roommate. You will get to know the environment around you. But yes, there are both pros and cons. If you want, within the second year, you need to focus only on your thesis or research work. Then you may need some silent zone, which you will always get in library and at your lab seat. But yes, stay within a room, you will get that benefit also. Along with that, if you feel alone, then so for those, sharing room will provide those opportunities. And regarding online and offline classes for this set, since the guidelines from Delhi government are still not open, so we are working on it. Any other question? By the way, we are done with the, like, we have already crossed the time limit. It is 8. So before we, yeah.
If I may quickly add here, this semester, most probably the classes will be held online because of the circumstances, but you will know more about it very soon once the final decision is taken.
So I would like to thank Ganesh, sir. It was really helpful from your end that you clarified their doubts. And there was one more question that is, what about the study load for the students, and do students of Delhi prefer hostels? Dinesh, I'm a Delhiite residing in Rohini, and the campus is in Okhla. It is like 1.5 hours, which is 35 kilometers from my home. I was staying in hostel because, yes, there were two reasons. One is obviously focus on work. The other is, you will get an exposure to IIIT Delhi campus. You will get an exposure to hostel life. My bachelor's college was just adjacent to my home. So I wanted to experience hostel life. So yes, most of the Delhi students also prefer hostels because of the enjoyment, life enjoyment, as well as to get more knowledge. The environment which will be around you within the campus will always be intellectual environment. So you will always keep on thinking if you have such intellectual environment around you. How is the workload of the for the program? Arvind, do you want to take this question?
Okay. So let me be more clear. The workload will be high. I don't want to go around the bush. You're gonna do a master's program, and that too in computational biology. But I will say this, that you will get enough time to focus on everything. IIITD is a research oriented and a focused institute, so it will make sure that you have roughly 4 assignments, if I just talk in relative terms, per course. So it will make sure that you are spending at least 4 to 5 hours every day spending on doing some assignments or reading something or preparing for your quizzes, assignments, your submissions. So in all, the workload will be high, but it is manageable. Eventually, when you join, you have this refresher course, which will basically get you on track with how the workload gonna be in the coming semester. So you will get used to it. About the question, so, about yeah. Ayushi, this is better you answer because you used to go home always.
Yeah. So last, the question is, another question asked by Vikash is, can we go to home during weekend? Dude, there's a saying from my friends that there's no weekend that I used to stay in campus. Every weekend I used to run to home. There are multiple reasons, like home cooked food again, and there's a like bunch of dirty clothes that I wanted to get washed. At our time, there was no washing machine facilities, but now there is a common washing machine facilities also within the campus where you can go and get your clothes clean, all these things. But yes, along with that, family always calls you back. So on every weekend, there is no weekend, I guess, I would have spent in the campus. Even my friends used to take care of the fact that, okay, since Ayushi has to go home, we will not make any plan for the weekend. We used to make all the outings, all our plans during weekdays because me and Nikita was also a Delhiite, is also a Delhiite. So we both used to go home on weekends. So, but yes, there is one thing. If you are going home on a weekend, there is a possibility that you will have a task on your plate to do, which you will be doing at your home. So don't think that if you are going home, you have nothing to do. You have more things to learn. But yes, you will get an opportunity to go home. There is no foundation. Even you can go home on your weekdays also if you don't have any class. So what are the documents we need to submit? Is there a document from a person coming from industrial background, joining on sabbatical from the... Okay, what are the documents we need to submit? Is there some document from person coming from the industrial background and joining on sabbatical from the industry side? Neeraj, I guess... for this question, we'll connect you to the academics department.
Ashutosh?
Yeah, Shipra.
For the documents, first of all, good evening to all. I was late due to some network issue. And regarding documents, we don't ask much document during admission. What all details you have given during your application, like your GATE score and your BTEC percentage. And this year we have mentioned about CGPA to percentage conversion undertaking and the certificate from your institute. So that will be very fine. And regarding sabbatical, yes, you need to submit NOC from your organization during your joining. However, looking at this current situation, means we'll be also giving time for all submitting all these documents. If you are not having that one, or you are getting it's been difficult for you to get it from your organization, then of course you will be getting time for that. But it's better that if you are coming for sabbatical, then you should get proper documentation and proper relieving from your organization so that there will not be any issue for you. And this is a MTech regular admission, so you will be considered as a regular student. So you need to be careful while taking sabbatical from your organization, and the company requirement will not be asking or contacting anything to the company regarding all this.
So
I hope I cleared your doubt.
Yes. Yeah, so a comment for you, sir, from Neeraj. Thank you. It was really helpful. So we have a question on stipend from Pratibha and Dinesh. Will it be paid to every student, every CB student, and will it impact our stipend because of classes being held online?
So classes being online, but TA location will also be there. So we need help from our TA during this online class as well. So TA allocation will be as per the previous practice, and they will be also getting the stipend from AICT. If suppose there is any notification from AICT, because you get the stipend scholarship from central government through AICT. So till date, we have not received any communication from AICT that you people will not get any stipend. However, that totally depends upon the announcement of central government through AICT, whether you will be getting it or not. But right now, all the students, last semester also, when it goes online, so all the students are getting stipend. I don't think there will be any issue further.
So there is one more point from Pratibha that will it be paid to everyone or do we have any criterias on that?
So those who will be taking TA duty, they will be TAC basically, they will be paid stipend. So the policy regarding this will be announced during their joining. When they will join on the first day of class itself, on the orientation itself, they will be informed regarding the TA, whether it is compulsory or they are having the choice to opt out of that TSF. So that will be informed to them on orientation. But most probably when a student take TSF, they get stipend. If they opt out of TSF, then they will not get stipend.
So there's a question from Kushal. Is mentor assigned to students in first sem itself? So Kushal, answer to your question is you are yourself a mentor. So other than this, but yes, your seniors, your super seniors and super super seniors will always be there to help you at any point of time. The only thing is you need to go and tell them you are going through this situation. Other than seniors, if you feel comfortable, you can reach out to your faculties. Shipra ma'am is there, Ashutosh sir is there. He will always be helping you in every aspect of your career. So one more question.
Right now there is a mentorship program for all the students. So I think student affairs department is taking care of that. So right now there are many faculty members who are taking initiative in this direction. So they will we are assigning some students to them as mentor. It was not there at the time of IUC when you were there. But right now there is a rigorous mentorship program which is planned and going on. So hopefully we'll have a proper mentor for each student. And we are also planning to, there was a plan for from alumni side also, which is currently there, that student mentorship program, so that they can means connect with alumni and get mentored.
Yeah. To add to what Ashutosh just mentioned, there will be mentors for both BTEC as well as MTEC student, and they will be allocated as early as possible, probably right from the first day itself.
So now what kind of resources or courses will be provided as the courses as the classes will be online? So during our masters also, Neeraj, we all used to refer to the online lectures that were being uploaded by the faculties. So faculties used to take the classes and as well as upload all the course material. So we have our college portal where all the courses material are being uploaded called Backpack, to which portal every student get the access. And for within that access, you will get the access for the courses which you have opted, and you can easily access those course material. But yes, what about those classes that we used to have face to face? Now they are going to happen online, and during your session you can easily go and ask your professor that what are the books you should refer and from where you should you can get this content. So and when are the classes expected to get started? Is it still first week of August or is there any delay?
So the academic calendar has been moved to August 20. This was a this will be for every year. Right now the academic the semester, first semester monsoon will start from August 20, and this is a new thing from your batch. And before that we'll of course have the preparatory module for CB, and how that will be done, mostly the preparatory and monsoon will be online. So how that will be done, what will be the thing you need to learn from there, and so all the details will be emailed to your register email ID.
Now there's one more question from Dinesh on stipend. What about stipend during semester breaks and the internship duration?
So internship duration, you will not be getting stipend if you are paid from that organization. That's the general rule for because you cannot get stipend from both the end, monetary fund from both the end. So
And during semester break also, there is no semester break for M.Tech students. So you will be there in the campus. Summer, you can utilize the summer. In summer also, you are allowed to take some credit. So you can utilize that summer. And there are provision in summer to give stipend to you. So so during that period also, you will be given stipend. You can just visit the AICT website or our website. All the details are given there. Maximum 24 months starting from your July, means the session when the session is going to start, you will get your stipend. For session, we need to check with AICT that how they are planning their academic calendar, because I think yesterday only there was a notification from UGC and AICT. So the when they will start the academic calendar from this academic year, suppose they are starting it from August, then you will get it till next July. The stipend will be for 24 months. If they are starting the session from July, then you will get it for next to next June, means for 2 years.
Thank you, sir. So there are more looks like the Neeraj is done with his questions, but still we are open to take your questions, the Neeraj. And there are some questions which were left unanswered in the during the session, starting with the question which was asked by Neeraj, question to Siddhant and Ayush. Does elective focus on omics data analysis? Siddhant?
There are a few electives where the course curriculum has been updated, and yeah, you will be studying the network sciences and AI ML and including the omics data analysis. And apart from that, you can also take an independent project or your thesis based on this domain.
Yeah, there is one more question from Sayan from for you, Siddhant. What type of TA duties needed to be done by CB student, and can it be done online as per the pandemic situation?
So earlier, the TA duties that varies from faculty to faculty. Some faculty only require you to check the assignments of the student, whereas other faculty requires you to take some doubt sessions or tutorial classes. And regarding online, since this situation has come up for the first time, I guess faculty will tell you what all duties you have to take. Maybe they ask you to evaluate the online assignments, or they may ask you to provide some lectures to them online.
Thank you, Siddhant. Is there any other question which we are missing, or maybe like someone wants to ask more questions? Yeah, there is one more question from Apur. Can you please mention the source from where I can learn basics of biology? Is 11-12 good enough, Siddhant and Ayush?
11-12 NCRT is good enough, but if you want some video lectures, you can refer to Khan Academy or the YouTube channel of Shomu's Biology.
Yeah, thank you, Siddhant. Guys, do we have more questions? So yeah, question to Sana and Divya. What is the career in data science after doing master's in CB, and is there a transition possible in the future from a career in CB to data science? Divya, would you like to take this question?
Yeah, actually you need to prepare yourself for CB prepares you for the data science, as it deals with a lot of data. And it depends on the company that you join, that if they want to convert you to a data science scientist, then it is possible.
Yeah, thank you, Divya. So is JRF compulsory for starting PhD, Divya?
No, it is not compulsory for starting PhD. It depends from institute to institutes, or every institute have their interview procedures, and you can, it is not compulsory for you.
Yeah,
it depends. So, let me just add here, it depends whether the PI or the mentor with whom you would like to join, whether they have a fellowship of their own from some other sources. If they have it, then you don't have to have your own JRF. Otherwise, you need to have your own funding. but oftentimes you do find somebody who is having their own fellowship, their own support, and you can continue working with them.
Yeah. So there is a comment from Dinesh Padiva. Thank you. Yeah. So we are looking for more questions. Thanks to Ganesh sir again for answering Anshul's question. We'll be getting guidance from seniors and faculties if we are looking forward for PhD after MTech. Neeraj, yes, every time you can reach out to any of your faculty or senior, irrespective of any kind of doubt, be it a silly doubt, be it a good doubt, either they will answer your question or they will tell you that who is the right person to reach for the question.
And one more thing I want to mention here, there is a provision from migrating to MTech to PhD in IIIT Delhi. So as IIIT Delhi is a research-led institute, so we always encourage research. So if anyone wants to migrate from MTech to PhD, then they might migrate it after first semester. They will get to interact with faculty, then to internal admission process. There are many processes, of course, for PhD admission. So they can contact a faculty member with their mutual interest of research, and they can, of course, migrate to PhD. And there will be some financial support for them from institutes. Say from last till last year, those who are migrating from MTech to PhD, the whole fee paid for MTech will be was refunded to them, and of course they will be getting PhD stipend, which is of course higher than MTech. So that's also a point I want to mention.
Thank you, sir. So Neeraj, to answer your question, so this was then overview of getting a PhD within IIIT Delhi and Indian institutes. And if you are looking for PhD from abroad, then yes, all possible help or support of faculty and seniors can do, they will do. Like if you are looking for letter of recommendations, if you are looking for your guidance while writing SOPs and all these things, yes. Even there are connections, like if a faculty has some connections within foreign universities, they will be happy to connect you and guide you. So there's one more question from Nesh. How will this pandemic impact CB industry in coming years? Shubhra, would you like to take this question?
Please go ahead.
No, Shubhra, go ahead. I was wondering whether you're around or not. Yeah.
As I said, right, like one word answer positively. We're already seeing, so India, in India, we have not had a lot of growth in the CB industry in the past, I would say in the past 10 years, at least it has not been comparable to how it has been in the US and Europe, right? But I think this is a time where people will really understand how important this kind of cross-functional research is when it comes to drug discovery, or whether it comes to informatics around this kind of COVID data. And I have not looked at the numbers, but I am pretty sure that if you look even 6 months down the line, you will see so many new entrepreneurs who are working in the CB field. It might not be exactly research, but it will be CB solutions at the least. We already have Biocon, and you have multiple subsidiaries of Biocon as well. You have SelectGene working in the CB industry already. I do see this pandemic positively influencing decision making and entrepreneurship in the future.
Yeah, thank you, Shubhra. Just to add on, this pandemic brought a great opportunity for CB industries, honestly speaking, because CB industries revolves around healthcare, genomics data, biological data, clinical data. All these are positively impacted because of this pandemic, because each and every hospital, all of these kind of solutions are being expected from CB industries, be it within India or outside India. But yes, it will be really helpful for us to have a solution within India. So this pandemic has brought up a positive impact on the CB industries. And I remember correctly, if I joined, there were only few industries. When I joined master's, I was wondering what are the list of those industries that I can join. But before I finished my master's, there was a list of industries that we could curate and go reach out to them. Yeah, so Neeraj Tripathi has also comment on your question that he's in TCS R&D department, and really this will hold future. Thank you, Neeraj. There is one more question from Pratibha. Biocon comes at campus placement. Does Biocon come at for the placement within campus?
Actually, Biocon didn't come for placements, but we are contacting it and hopefully it will come.
So, Pratibha.
And the IOC, you can tell them about the Vaskaro app, which was developed by our faculty. And the app used by Delhi government, that's also developed by our faculty and students.
So there is one faculty within our campus, Dr. Tavpritesh Sethi. He is directly working with the Delhi government for various various pandemic situation solutions. Like there is an app called Wash Karo, which is being developed by his lab. And each member of his lab is contributing very positively for that. This Wash Karo is more about reminding you the precautions and precautions that has to be taken care for the COVID-19 in various languages. Along with that, students under his supervision has contributed to the Delhi government in creating an app which is more about giving an analysis and the statistical values of the beds availability within Delhi hospitals, which is being carried forward by the government to the various hospitals. And you can easily go and check what are the hospitals, what are the beds, what is the bed count available at which hospital. And along with that, they are also working on more projects related to COVID data within their lab only. And that is also in collaboration with Professor PK, who is a CSE faculty. So there is like a big scope of collaboration in different branches, like CB department collaborates with CSE department, CSE department is open to collaborate with CB, similar with EC department and mathematics department. So other faculties from various departments are collaborating with each other. So there's one more point from Siddhant. Will we get ample guide? Yeah, Arvind.
I will just add to this that I just saw like few days back, announcement about this hackathon from the Department of Science and Technology and DBT, in which I guess Arjun Ray, the faculty in IIT Delhi, is an expert mentor and is also part of it. And also I would like to just add that all the faculties from IIT Delhi are actually involved in a lot of different projects at different level, whether be related to COVID or be to other domains. So obviously there is a lot of impact created by IIIT Delhi CB department, especially in the field of CB and research. And it is also known outside India also. I can tell you from my personal experience being in Switzerland over here, people do know about what kind of research does different faculty from IIIT Delhi do. So that's even a big plus point. I just wanted to add this point.
Thank you, Arvind. So there is one more question from Siddhant. Like, is CB students allowed to appear for CSE companies? Divya?
Yes, all the CB students are allowed allowed to sit for CSE companies, except for a few companies that have their own criteria. And we are allowed for most of the companies.
Okay, thank you, Divya. So there is one more question from Dinesh. Do we have an alumni working in Microsoft and IBM research labs in CB domain? To answer your question, Dinesh, we have alumni working in Dunhumby as data scientists, Accenture as data scientists. I was about to join Paytm. So we have alumni in our CB department who has been by joining a good set of companies for CB domain within Microsoft and IBM, they are not currently working in India. So for Microsoft, it is in in case of IBM, it is in Watson. So which is something like, at least my at my end, I was preferring India. Within India, these companies are coming up. Like there was a news from IBM last year that they are creating a new team within for CB domain within India, and its branch will be in Bangalore and Delhi campus. But for sure, for now, it is still they are in the incubation phase. So they have not started. They are planning. So there is one more question from Siddhant. Like CAC students in particular, I was curious to know the subject that I can pursue along with CB subjects. Question to Siddhant and Ayush.
Hello.
So you can take up the elective of the CS department. Like you can go for statistical machine learning or graduate algorithm, such type of electives, if you want to enhance or improve your skill in that particular domain.
Thank you, Siddhant. There is one question for Shipra. Do we upload these sessions on YouTube or somewhere where these sessions can be accessed by by the students?
Yes, we are planning to do so. Once we'll upload it, we'll notify the same on the Facebook and the Twitter handles of CB department.
Okay. Thank you, Shipra. So there is a question from Nitesh. If we go for campus placement, what will be the opportunities for growth in working sector? Sana and Divya, would you like to take this question?
For growth in the working sector, is he talking? I mean, I would want a little more clarity on that question, honestly.
Okay, sorry to interrupt, Sana, but I would say Shubhra is already in industry, I guess, since you are in a PhD. Shubhra, why don't you take this question for growth? What from where you started? Shubhra got campus placement in LUC Data.
I joined Elucid Data as a data science intern in 2017, summer of 2017, and I've been there ever since. So I was an intern for 6 months, then I did my thesis there. Then I joined as a C++ developer for a CB application, which required a lot of understanding of the algorithms, and like I was basically managing the core of that app. After that, as soon as I joined as a full-time employee, I was the team lead for a 5-person team working on that app. 1 year after that, I was promoted to a senior bioinformatics engineer at Elucid Data, wherein I manage and develop and maintain all the algorithmic packages that we have running behind our pipelines. And even after that, right, if you want, you can also switch over to bioinformatics scientist role, where honestly you have, and even my position, right, I got the opportunity to not just work on the software, I also got to lead a team, I got to collect requirements, I got to work as a product person, I got to work as a marketing person, I got to work interacting with the clients, and the clients in this case being eminent researchers at either an academic lab at Yale or at MIT, et cetera. So you get a lot of exposure, and even after that, right, I have two colleagues at Elucid Data who are working in a similar domain as mine, who actually got a research assistantship at one of the Yale academic labs, and they're doing pretty good, pretty well for themselves. I think one of them even joined a PhD at Yale. Sticking to industrial sector, you definitely have a lot of growth to expect. It's not, I won't say it's comparable to software engineer, like pure software engineer, but it's definitely getting better every year.
Thank you, Shubhra. Just to add on her points, I joined an organization in 2017 as an intern, a data scientist intern. And I have been promoted to consultant for data sciences within that organization, along with the support to my PhD. So yes, there is a huge scope of growth within a working sector. The only thing is given the fact that you are giving your best and contributing positively to the organization. So is 6 month internship done after 1 year or at the last of second year? So the primary, Dinesh, just to answer your point, is the primary point key is you first need to complete all your course credit, or if still you have pending course credit, you can go for internship after your first year. Please correct me, Ashutosh sir, if there is some miscommunication.
So come again. Actually, I did not.
Yeah. So is 6 month internship done after 1 year or at the last of second year?
So currently only summer internship is allowed. Okay.
Yes, sir.
For this base, and there are different options like industrial thesis and other internship policies are being discussed. So when they will join, they will know about 6 month internship and other things.
Thank you, sir. So there's a question from Partha regarding last date of withdrawal of seat and getting full admission feedback. Partha, yes, for now it is 24th July, but because of all these COVID and pandemic situations, there is a chance or scope of getting this withdrawal date extended. But for now it is 24th July. And along with that, is as per the schedule of online classes, do we have to get into hostels first or we can attend online classes from home? I guess there are no hostel facility if I remember currently because of pandemic. Or please correct me, Ashutosh sir.
Yeah, it's correct. Right now, all the thing will be online. No one is allowed to enter the campus right now. Okay. So
yeah.
We need to abide by the rule of government. So currently, no one knows. It will be online. They can attend the classes from their home. So, if they are not, means.
Thank you, sir. There is another question from Sayan regarding companies. So, if we are working within a product-based company, do we have night shifts or flexible working hours are available? Shubhra.
Yeah, so at Elucidata, we don't really have night shifts, although we're working with the companies based in the US and Europe. But yeah, flexible hours for sure. I'm not exactly sure what you're looking for here in the answer, but at least I have not heard of night shifts in product-based companies.
Yeah. Just it reminded me of something that Shubhra mentioned, that she has started working on C and C++ skills during her job. She's coming from a biotech background. And now she's also working with the computation like Python, product development. So this is something you can easily see how CB course has, enhanced her skills of computational along with her biological skills.
Oh, right, yeah. Shubhra? I have so much to say when it comes to how the CB course prepared me for my job at Elucidata, not just as a CB developer, but like overall, like all the responsibilities that I had over the past 3 years. If anybody would if they want to connect, I have shared my email ID here and they can kind of contact me and I'll be happy to share.
Yeah, so Shubhra has written a paragraph of her thoughts with the shared email ID. So you guys can go through it and easily connect to her. Do we have more questions? I guess we all are ready to take more questions. Since it's already 8:40 or 8:39, let's wrap it up. There are thanks comments from Nitesh, Dinesh, Partha, and others. Along with these, we as a team are So there is a request from Pratibha. Can we have email from CAC alumni graduated? Yes, Pratibha, we all before end will share our email IDs and our backgrounds, bachelor's backgrounds, so that you can easily reach out to us. I request everyone within the group to share their email IDs within the chat box so that they can easily reach out to us and their backgrounds also, bachelor's and master's background. It will be really helpful for them. So before we finish it, then I request everyone to push right mention their email IDs. Allow us one more minute to mention our email IDs. So by the time others are mentioning their email IDs, I would really thank to everyone of you to join us and spare your time, gave us an opportunity to share our experiences. It was really helping and supporting from your end. I know we have already taken 40 or 42 minutes extra than the estimated time. It was not expected like this, but it is really good to have this kind of discussion with you guys. Because of this pandemic situation, it was more of one way. But yes, once the campus reopens, we all will be available to answer your queries. Your seniors, your super seniors, and some PhDs who have been converted from masters to PhD are always available.